Good morning, children. Welcome to our video lecture. Today, we are going to start with a new topic in geography, that is lesson number 5, winds. Now, children, we all are familiar with the winds. Many a times, we experience a cold breeze, or in the summer season, we feel hot. And that time we see there is no breeze or there is no wind. But do you all know there are different types of winds? Yes, today we are going to study different types of winds. How these winds are occurring? What is the reason behind occurring of the winds? And what are the different names of these winds in the different areas of the world? All these things we are going to study in our today's lesson. So, now let us begin with the explanation of this lesson. We have learned that the air pressure is not uniform across the Earth's surface. Now, children, in our previous lesson, we have already studied that the air pressure is not uniform or it is not same across the Earth's surface. Air moves from high pressure areas towards low pressure area. Now, here in this figure 5.2, you can see the change of the direction of winds, in which you can see the air is moving from the high pressure belt or the high pressure area towards the low pressure. This red color mark, you can see it is moving upwards, it is moving downwards, and then it is getting combined here. Here you can see there are the directions which are turning from the left hand side and from the left right hand side. These are the directions, or these are the change into the direction because of the rotation. Okay, so now let's see. Areas in a horizontal manner, winds are generated due to this movement. The extent of the difference in the air pressure affects the velocity of the wind. So wherever the air pressure changes, the velocity of the wind also gets affected. If there is less difference in the pressure, winds blow with less velocity. So if there is less difference in the pressure, then the wind which is blowing has a less velocity or a less speed. Winds blow with greater velocity if the pressure difference is greater. So if the pressure difference is greater, then the wind is having more velocity or it is having a great speed. Wind speed also varies. Wind velocity is measured in the units of knots or kilometers per hour. When we consider the Earth as a whole, we find the direction of the wind is influenced by the rotation of the Earth. In the northern hemisphere, winds get deflected, that is, turned towards the right of their original direction, whereas in the southern hemisphere, they get deflected towards the left of their original direction. See figure 5.2. So already we had seen, once again we will see. See here, you can see in the north, when they are moving upwards, they are going to their right hand side, and we are coming down, moving towards the south, they are coming down, they are again moving towards the left hand side. So this is happening. See here, all the direction which are going towards south, they are moving towards the left hand side, and which are going in the north, they are going towards the right hand side. Okay, this is in the northern hemisphere, and in the southern hemisphere it is opposite. The winds which are going upward, they are moving towards the left hand side, and the winds which are going downwards, they are going towards the right hand side. So why this happen? Because of the air pressure and the velocity of wind. Okay, so in then that this direction has been shown by curved arrow in the figure which we have already seen. The rotation from west to east causes this change in the original direction of the wind. So because the earth is rotating, and because of the rotation of the earth, the original direction of the wind which is there, that takes that changes according to the rotation of the earth and the direction in which the wind is blowing. Okay, now we are going to study about the different types of winds. Here you can see there is a planetary wind and the pressure belt on the earth. Winds are known by the direction from which they blow. For example, westerlies are the winds that blow from the west. The direction of blowing, the duration, the region covered, and the condition of the air determine the following wind type. So here what they had given, let's see. This is the earth which is given here. You can see already in the previous lesson also we had seen this equatorial low pressure belt, mid latitudinal high pressure belt, polar wind, subpolar low pressure belt. Now here in this you can see the winds which are moving from east to west, they are known as easterlies. Okay, and the winds which are moving from west to east, they are known as westerlies. Here also you can see the winds which are moving from east to west, they are easterlies, and west to east, they are known as easterlies. So same what is given here explanation, let's see. Winds are known by the direction from which they blow. So accordingly, if they are blowing from west, they are known as westerlies, and if they are blowing from east, they are known as easterlies. The direction of blowing, the duration, for how long time they are blowing, whether they are blowing for 1 day, 1 hour, or half day, or for 4 to 5 hours, accordingly the duration, the time period. The regions covered, in which area they are blowing, where they are blowing in the equatorial pressure belt, they are blowing in the tropical zone, they are blowing in the temperate zone, freezed zone, which area they are blowing, which region they are covering, and the condition of the air, what type of air is blowing. So all this is determining, or all this is deciding the types of wind. Okay, so now we are going to study about the planetary winds. Some winds blow regularly on the earth from high to low pressure belt throughout the year. These winds cover a large portion of the earth, hence these are called planetary winds. So thus there are some type of winds which are blowing throughout the year, and they are continuously blowing on the earth from high pressure to the low pressure belt, and thus this portion, they are covering the large area on the earth, so they are known as planetary winds. For example, the easterlies and the westerlies and the polar winds. So there are easterlies, westerlies and polar winds. These winds are moving continuously on the earth's surface, and thus they are categorized into planetary winds. In both the hemispheres, the winds blow from the high pressure areas between 25 degree and 35 degree parallel to the equatorial low pressure belt. So children, you can see here in this figure, they had given in both the hemisphere, that is, this is the equator, in the north pole and in the south pole, the winds blow from the high pressure belt to areas between 25 and 35 degree to the equatorial low pressure belt. So you can see this is a high pressure belt which is formed. Okay, so from your high pressure belt, they are blowing towards the equatorial low pressure belt. Here also you can see this is from mid latitudinal high pressure belt, they are blowing towards the mid latitudinal to the equatorial low pressure belt, that is from 25 degree to 35 degree in the south pole, 25 degree to 35 degree in the north pole, and both are moving from the east direction. So let's see. Due to the rotation of the earth, their original direction changes. In the northern hemisphere, they blow from the northeast to the southwest, whereas in the southern hemisphere, they blow from the southeast to the northwest. So here you can see in the picture clearly, in the northern hemisphere, okay, they are blowing from the northeast to the southwest. Okay, this is the east part, and they are blowing from northeast to the southwest, whereas in the southern hemisphere, they are blowing from the southeast to the northwest. Okay, and thus they are moving from both the sides, they are moving from the east side. These winds coming from both the sides converge near the equatorial calm belt. These winds are known as the Easterlies. So as they are coming from both the sides, from the east side, and they are converging, they are getting converted near the equatorial calm belt, and thus they are known as Easterlies. Okay, so this is known as Easterlies. In similar manner, we are going to study about the Westerlies. In both the hemisphere, winds blow from the middle latitudinal high pressure to the subpolar low pressure belt situated near 60 degree parallel. Now here in the figure you can see, in the both the hemisphere, once again winds blow from the mid latitudinal high pressure belt. Okay, so mid latitudinal high pressure belt, here is also mid latitudinal high pressure belt, to the subpolar low pressure belt. They are moving towards the subpolar low pressure belt in the northern hemisphere, in the southern hemisphere, situated near 60 degree parallel. Okay, so they are moving near 60 degree on both the sides. Their original direction changes due to the rotation of the earth. In the southern hemisphere, these winds blow from the northwest to the southeast. So here we can see in the southern hemisphere, these winds are blowing from the northwest to the southeast, and in the northern hemisphere, they blow from southwest to the northeast. This direction are called Westerlies. Okay, so these winds are called as Westerlies. You can see here Westerlies and Westerlies. In both the hemisphere, winds blowing from the polar high pressure belt to the subpolar low pressure belt. Here you can see these are polar winds. In both the hemisphere, from the polar high pressure belt to the subpolar low pressure belt, that is from 55 degree to 65, are called polar winds. Generally, they blow from east to west. So they are blowing from east to west. Okay, so this is about the different types of polar winds. They are Easterlies, Westerlies, and polar winds. Now after this, we are going to study about the local winds. Before studying local winds, let us see in a little bit in short. Winds in the southern hemisphere blow with great velocity. The southern hemisphere is mostly occupied by ocean. In this hemisphere, the obstacle caused by the relief of the land surface is almost absent. As there is no obstacle, winds blow with greater velocity in the southern hemisphere. As compared to the northern hemisphere, their characteristics are as follows. Beyond 40 degrees south, winds blow with tremendous velocity. These winds are called roaring 40s. Around 50 degrees south, winds are stormy. Hence, they are called furious 50s. The stormy winds around 60 degrees south makes tremendous noise, and hence they are called screeching 60s. Okay, so thus according to their different sound which has been made by the wind, they are named differently. The next we are going to study about local winds. Winds that blow for the short duration of time originate in the specific region and blow over a limited area are called local winds. So the winds they are getting generated for a specific time period, they are moving or they are blowing only for a certain time, and they are over a limited area. They are called as local winds. Local winds affect the climate of the region where they blow. So local winds are affecting the climate only in the place or the region where they are blowing. These winds are known by different local names in the different regions where they blow. So as already I had told you all at the beginning, these local winds, they are known by the names in which region they are blowing, and accordingly they are been named. So let us see about their naming, not in detail, we will just see in a short. Major local winds in the world, name of the wind, they are low, simon, chinook, mistral, bora, pampero and fawn or fohan. Accordingly, in which area they are moving, here in this chart on your page number 26 in your textbook, a chart is given where you can see major local winds in the world. So accordingly, you can read their names, the nature of the wind and in which area they are blowing. You can study about it carefully. Okay, so I hope you have understood about the planetary winds and local winds. The next part of this lesson we will continue in our second video. Thank you.